Hello, for my Form 5 students. Today we are here to continue our lesson in the chapter Redox Reaction Part 7, page 118 to 119 from this module. Page 118 to 119 from this module. Okay, so we are still in the subtopic of rusting as redox reaction. In our previous video, teacher have discussed regarding the how does rusting happen, and today we are going to discuss and also teacher forgot to tell you, teacher proved that rusting is a redox reaction where iron is reducing agent becomes oxidized, and hydroxide ion from the water is the oxidizing agent. Okay, hydroxide ion. So please look back at our video part 6. Okay, so hydroxide ion, which is a reducing, sorry, oxidizing agent, has gone through reduction. It's actually your oxide. Okay, so your oxide. Okay, so from there we can conclude that rusting is actually a redox reaction. Now we are going to look at fuse, the same subtopic, but we are going to discuss rusting as a redox reaction, and we are going to look at an experiment from page 119 where which metal inhibits or co-inhibits the rusting of iron. Before we do this experiment, you have to understand two concepts, okay, few explanation on concepts on rusting as redox reaction. Okay, now the first concept is effect of other metals on rusting. Now what happens is, can you see that iron is situated here? So remember, rusting is used especially for iron. So our main concept is on iron. So please remember, all the metals that comes before iron are easier to donate electron, and these metals are tougher to donate electron. Not to say tougher, when compared to iron, these metals are easier to donate electron. When iron comes into contact with this metal, iron will rust faster. Okay, so teacher repeat. Because here the affinity, the ability to donate electron is faster. That means the metals are more electropositive here. Okay, the metals are less electropositive here. Okay, so that is the reason why that can determine how fast iron can rust when it comes into contact with certain other metals. Alright, okay, now so let's go to this discussion where a more electropositive metal versus iron. Meaning, here are more electropositive metal. That means you put your iron as a benchmark. Here is a benchmark. So this is less electropositive than iron. This is more electropositive because easier to donate electron. Now, when you put this metal in contact with iron, okay, in contact with iron, you'll be surprised to find iron don't donate electron. Okay, metal donate electron, or you can say other metal donate electron, thus iron don't rust. Okay, so teacher repeat, when you put a metal, especially iron, in a contact with a more electropositive metal, iron cannot donate electron already. Because when you lawan iron dengan, for instance, magnesium, iron dengan aluminium, iron dengan zinc, sodium, calcium, potassium, you will find that iron cannot donate electron because these metals will start donating electron first. So iron cannot rust. So actually iron is actually cohibitor, sorry, inhibited from rusting. Sebenarnya diselamatkan daripada mengarat. Okay, actually it has been saved from rusting. But what happens when a less electropositive, when a less electropositive metal comes into contact with iron? Let's say I put iron with a metal called copper. What happens is iron donate electron, because iron is considered, because iron is here, your copper is here, iron is considered more electropositive already. So iron will start donating electron. Okay, other metal don't donate electron, so iron rust. Okay, iron will start rusting. So this shows that when you combine iron with a more electropositive metal, that metal actually saves iron from rusting. Now if you combine iron with a least electropositive metal than itself, it will actually cohibit, membantu, okay, cohibit iron to rust. Okay, so that is the reason why when you put two metals together, we have to be very, very careful. Okay, it might make the iron rust or the other metal start donating electron. Alright, now if I hope you can remember chapter 6, form 4, electrochemistry, a concept where further the pair of metals in electrochemical series, higher the voltage. So the same concept you can apply here, where the distance of metal in ECS, just assume this is ECS, when the distance of metal in the ECS is further, the rusting is faster. For instance, compact, that means we know the moment I pair up iron and stainum, definitely iron is going to rust, but the rusting is faster in when I compare, when I mix iron and lead, when I mix iron and copper. Why? Because the distance is further. Okay, teacher Ripina, when you combine with all these metals, iron is definitely going to rust. But now we are going to look at how fast iron can start donating electron or start rusting. So what happens is, when I combine iron with stainum and I combine iron with copper, you will find that the rate of rusting for combination of iron and copper is faster compared to rate of rusting between iron and stainum. Why? Further the distance, more distant the metal, faster rusting. Okay, faster the rusting is. Okay, so that is what I want you to understand before we go to this experiment. Please refer to page 119. 118 and 119 for this experiment. This is actually one of the toughest experiment because a lot of concept is involved and also a popular paper 3 question. Alright, okay, now so if you look at your diagram, I want you to look at your diagram when you are listening to teacher's video. I want you to look at this diagram for your further information. Teacher, actually your module is only discussing two types of test tube, two types of combination, but teacher have added a third type of combination for our further discussion. Okay, now when you see all the test tube contains potassium, substance called potassium hexocyanoferrate 3, agar and also phenolphthalein, I have to explain what is the function of all these three. Right, now potassium hexacyanoferrate 3, actually the function of this is to detect Fe2+. The moment it detects Fe2+, it has dark blue. dark blue spots. It produces dark blue substance. You can even refer to chapter 8, form 4, a special identification for iron 2 and iron 3 ion. You'll be finding this color, potassium hexacyanoferrite 2 and potassium hexacyanoferrite 3 can help to determine the presence of iron 3 and iron 2. Right? Okay, now so agar actually provides solution, which is water solution consisting of course hydroxide and hydrogen ion. Okay, and phenolphthalein actually is used to detect hydroxide ion. Okay, it is used to detect hydroxide ion. Now, you need to know why all these three colors are added into the test tube. All the test tube are added into each of these three substances are added into each of these test tubes. Now, look at the combination of the metals. Iron, this is iron nail versus magnesium, iron nail versus copper, iron nail versus stannum. Okay guys, if you look at this combination here, can you determine between iron and magnesium who donates electron faster? Okay, so please refer here. Magnesium is more electropositive than iron, so magnesium will start donating electron faster. Magnesium will start donating electron faster. So this shows that iron nail is saved from rusting. So iron won't rust. And here, look at here, copper and iron. Copper and iron versus stannum and iron. So this shows that in both of these, iron will start donating electron. Fe2+. Okay, so now, but when you compare this and this test tube, you will find that the iron is rusting faster here. Okay, you will find that the iron is rusting faster here compared to iron and stannum combination. Why? Because the distance between iron and copper is further compared to iron and stannum. So that is the reason why you can find, yes, both of them you can see iron 2 ion produced, but here is faster because of the distance between iron and copper. Alright, now let's go to one by one. So teacher going to discuss what can be seen in one. Okay, now since you can't detect the presence of iron 2 ion in test tube 1, you can find no dark blue spots. Okay, no dark blue spots. Okay, no dark blue spots. You have pink and no dark blue spots and you have pink color. Okay, you have pink color. Why? Because no pink color. You find hydrogen gas bubbles formed. Okay, hydrogen gas bubble formed. And here, let's look at number 2, dark blue spots Fe2+. You will find pink color and you find gas bubbles. Okay, you find gas bubbles. Now let's look at number 3. Same dark spots. You find pink color and you find gas bubbles. Okay, now the reason for this. Okay, now the reason for this gas bubble is equivalent to hydrogen gas bubbles. Now allow me to explain. Okay, why you don't get dark blue spots in number one is because magnesium ion produces. Magnesium ion is produced in test tube 1. So since potassium hexacyanoferrate 3 only can detect Fe2+, only can detect Fe2+, that's why you don't see dark blue spots. Now, why do you have hydrogen gas bubbles? Because hydrogen gas bubbles go through this. Can you see you have hydrogen ion? Okay, so you have hydrogen ion will receive 2 electrons to become hydrogen gas. This is what happens inside the test tube. Okay, and you might be thinking, teacher, why here got pink color, here no pink color? What happens is, this is, then what happens is, can you see you have after hydrogen ion has been taken to produce hydrogen gas bubbles, this happens. Final step, magnesium 2+ will, magnesium 2 plus will with the hydroxide ion, 2 hydroxide ions only, will react with 2 hydroxide ion to become magnesium hydroxide. Okay, magnesium hydroxide. So that is the reason why your phenolphthalein cannot detect hydroxide ion. Okay, so your phenolphthalein cannot detect hydroxide ion because your magnesium ion has started to react with hydroxide ion, the leftover hydroxide ion, to produce magnesium hydroxide. Okay, so teacher repeat, no dark blue because instead of iron, magnesium started to donate electron thanks for magnesium being more electropositive. Hydrogen gas bubble produced because someone is giving electron. Can you see? Magnesium is giving electron going through oxidation. Since rusting is a redox process, someone has to receive electron. So hydrogen ion from the water molecule, from the water solution, okay, produces hydrogen gas. That's why you can see hydrogen gas bubbles produced. And why there is no pink color? Because the magnesium ion started to react with your hydroxide ion to produce magnesium hydroxide. Okay, now let's go to here. Dark blue spots, guys. Why dark blue? Because here and here, teacher can use the same observations or the same inference. Okay, why dark blue spots? Because there is presence of iron 2+. Because when you have presence of 2+, you have dark blue spots. But when teacher compare, you can find here dark blue spots is higher compared to here. Alright? Okay, now why hydrogen gas bubbles? Why the hydrogen gas bubbles is produced? Because of this. Okay, now why pink color is being produced? You might be thinking, teacher, the same happens. Actually, no. Okay, sphenium and your copper ion usually won't react with hydroxide ion. Okay, or else you produce like precipitation because they are bases. So that is the reason why hydroxide ion is present. It will take a long time. Actually, usually copper hydroxide takes a very long time to be produced. Okay, sometimes it won't be produced also. Because sphenium oxide and your copper oxides are bases, so they prefer to be in base form rather than hydroxide form. Alright, so what happens is, so since hydrogen has been taken away to become hydrogen gas, tinggal hydroxide ion saja. So who detects the hydroxide ion? Phenolphthalein, which turns pink color. Okay, thanks to phenolphthalein, it changes pink. Okay, detects hydroxide ion pink. The moment you have hydroxide ion, it changes to pink color. Okay, so that's why pink color. Okay, so that is the observation for this experiment. Please remember that this experiment is actually a very famous chapter paper 3 question. Okay, or also famous question for chapter 3 also. Okay, so that's why I want you to understand. Okay, even though the explanation in your module is very very simple, teacher have put some extra effort to explain the presence of pink color and also gas bubbles. Okay, so I hope all of you can understand what teacher have explained. Teacher will see you all in our next video. Okay, thanks for watching guys. See you all.